gray market where people are changing their forex in foreign countries at higher rates when they don't have any other sources. And yeah, the localists kind of try to take advantage of the foreigners. So yeah, an app like MoneyHop is a breakthrough, which gives people this power where can do that at their fingertips. But I'd just like to know, how that gray market functions. And as if a student is stranded at some place, and suppose there's and to reach to a network related place or somewhere needs time, how to save? I know it's not entirely related to MoneyHop, but it's a very big generalized problem which people don't talk about. So how to save yourself from those frauds of people who are trying to take advantage of you, and how to be safe from the gray market stuff and, exchange at like a good rate for you.
I think one of the primary, I think gray market should be avoided at any cost. Not only are they not legal, they can also land you into bigger governmental problems. Money laundering is something that every government takes very, very seriously because we don't know what the origination of those funds are and for what purpose have they been used prior to being handed over to you, right? And what tends to happen is whenever there is any criminal activity involved, they will track the source of the fund till when it is used. So very important to kind of avoid these markets. I think I think what is happening in the world is that the money is moving digital, right? Which is a great thing because the traceability of the funds is higher, and the probability of you losing the money, unless of course there's a cybersecurity threat, is also lower, right? So being on top of so if you go to London and if you were to kind of pull out, I remember once when my parents had come from Dehradun and they had bought a bunch of 50 pound notes and we went to High Street branch and we wanted to buy something. The guy who was a Brit, 28 year old, had never seen a 50 pound note in his life. So he had to call his manager and get it validated to say that, okay, is this even original or not, right? So my point is that the Western economy is certainly moving digital, and so are we here in India, right? I mean, if you can look at the UPI transactions, they have gone through the roof. So I think the governments are also moving in that direction where the dependency on the cash is less, and we're moving towards a cashless society. And we, as the youth of today, we as people who are traveling abroad for education and so on and so forth, should certainly adopt to that and prevent the usage of currency as large as possible. Because not only will you prevent yourself to any frauds, you're also doing something better for the environment and moving towards a presenceless, paperless, and a cashless economy.